Hello everyone. A new hope in the fight against AIDS has emerged with the recent announcement from the American pharmaceutical company Gilead. This announcement has generated significant interest within the scientific community dedicated to combating HIV. Gilead has revealed promising results for a new preventive treatment currently in clinical trials, offering 100% protection against the virus. This treatment, Lenacapavir, is being tested as part of pre-exposure prophylaxis, PrEP, a prevention method for individuals at risk of HIV infection. So far, PrEP has relied on Truvada, a combination of two antiretroviral drugs also used to treat those already infected. What sets Lenacapavir apart is its mode of action. Unlike current treatments that target viral enzymes, this new molecule acts on the HIV capsid, a structure containing the virus's genetic material. Lenacapavir causes the dissociation of the capsid's components, thereby preventing the virus from replicating. Additionally, this molecule has a prolonged action duration, allowing for much less frequent administration compared to traditional daily treatments. Clinical trial participants received a subcutaneous injection every 6 months, a simple method that eliminates adherence issues. Once injected, Lenacapavir provides protection against HIV for 6 months. The trial, conducted on 5,000 women, showed 100% efficacy. In comparison, the control group receiving standard PrEP achieved efficacy rates of 95% to 100%, as irregular medication adherence can reduce effectiveness, which is common with daily medications. Although this treatment is already available for individuals with drug-resistant viruses, several steps remain before it can be marketed as a preventive treatment. A trial is currently underway involving men to verify if Lenacapavir's efficacy is similar to that observed in women. Results are expected by the end of the year or early 2025. Following this, the drug will need to pass regulatory authorities, such as the FDA in the United States or the European Medicines Agency, before becoming widely available. This new treatment could represent a major breakthrough in HIV prevention, especially in regions where access to care and adherence to treatments are challenging. Transitioning from a curative to a preventive treatment is not unusual in the field of HIV therapy. The principle remains the same: to prevent the virus's replication. However, as with any antiretroviral treatment, there is a risk of developing resistant viruses. For this reason, Lenacapavir is not yet prescribed to everyone. Laboratory and patient studies have shown that the virus could, in some cases, develop resistance. To counter this, strategies may include combining Lenacapavir with another molecule. Resistance means that the virus can mutate, adapt, and thus escape the treatment's effects, making it impossible to stop viral replication. Although this risk is theoretical and has not yet been observed in ongoing trials, it remains a concern, especially with the potential emergence of resistant viruses, similar to new coronavirus variants. It is likely that therapeutic strategies will need to be adapted in the future. Lenacapavir specifically targets HIV by acting on the virus's capsid and preventing its replication. However, this mechanism differs from that of a vaccine. A vaccine, such as the mRNA vaccines for coronavirus, stimulates the body's immune responses by triggering the production of specific proteins, allowing the body to generate protective antibodies. In contrast, Lenacapavir is a medication that requires a new injection every 6 months as it does not train the immune system. One of the main advantages of this new preventive treatment is that it does not require daily intake, unlike traditional PrEP. However, while standard PrEP shows an efficacy of 95% to 100%, its effectiveness in practice is often compromised by poor adherence, meaning many people do not take it correctly. This contributes to nearly 1.3 million new infections each year worldwide. Most new infections occur in developing countries, particularly in sub-Saharan Africa. It is crucial to make these treatments accessible to at-risk populations, including men who have sex with men, transgender individuals, and sex workers. In the absence of a vaccine, these preventive treatments are essential, but must be accompanied by major policy decisions. Another challenge is the high cost of this new medication, which exceeds that of traditional PrEP, especially in Europe and the United States. Pricing adjustments for target countries and the establishment of appropriate care structures will be necessary. Additionally, it is crucial to combine this treatment with other prevention methods to reduce not only HIV, but also other sexually transmitted infections. Thank you for your attention.